Hello and welcome to our series of Target Prelims 2019. Coming to the first topic for discussion, it is the Digital India Scheme. Now, just as I had mentioned in the Swachh Bharat Mission also, these are some schemes which are always open for questioning, and not knowing an answer on these important and major schemes is something that is unforgivable in UPSC prelims now. So you should be very well prepared, at least with these major schemes. Now, coming to the aim of the scheme, the aim here is to transform India into a digitally empowered society as well as into a knowledge economy. Also, what is important here is that this scheme is coordinated by the Department of Electronics and IT, but it is implemented by all the government departments and it is monitored by the Digital India Committee. So if a question is asked on coordination, implementation and monitoring, it is done by three different agencies, and that is something that can be, cause some degree of confusion to students. So please keep an eye for this. Also, next, what is important is the three core components of this particular scheme. The first is about creation of digital infrastructure. Next is about delivering services digitally. And the third is vis-a-vis digital literacy. So these are the three core components. Next, what is important is that this is an umbrella program, including the National Optical Fiber Network. And it aims at connecting 2.5 lakh gram panchayats by providing internet connectivity to all the citizens. So these some figures are what are important. These 2.5 lakh villages is something that can be asked. Also, what is important is that this includes development of an electronic fund, electronic development fund, and ensuring a net zero electronic import by 2020. So this is one objective of the scheme that students may tend to miss. So please keep this in mind also. Next, what is important are the nine pillars of Digital India. The first is e-governance, reforming government through technology. Next is e-kranti, which is electronic delivery of services. Then information technology for jobs is one of the pillars. Next is the idea of early harvest programs. Next is electronics manufacturing. Also information for all, public interest access programs, universal access to mobile connectivity and broadband highways. So these are the nine pillars. You should read them once, so that if a question is what is asked on them, at least you are in a position to identify few and eliminate few. So that is how you can easily reach to the right answer. So that is about this particular scheme. Coming to the next scheme, which is the National Action Plan for Climate Change. Now, basically, this is a comprehensive action plan for the climate change that is related to, first and foremost, adaptation as well as mitigation while simultaneously advancing development. So this is one of the rare schemes that is for climate change and how India is going to adapt, mitigate and develop in the backdrop of climate change. So this scheme is being one of the rare schemes on climate change. It becomes a very, very important scheme. Also, the implementation is done by the Prime Minister's Council on Climate Change. Now, there are eight core missions under this particular scheme, which is the crux of the scheme. Questions will be asked from this part only. Now, first and foremost, this scheme has the first mission of National Solar Mission. Next, there is a National Mission on Enhanced Energy Efficiency. Next, there is a National Mission on Sustainable Habitat. There is a National Mission on Water. Also, there is a National Mission for a Green India. There is a National Mission for Sustaining the Himalayan Ecosystem. There is a National Mission on Strategic Knowledge for Climate Change. And there is a National Mission on Sustainable Agriculture. So this is something that is important. You should try to make some mnemonic for this or whatever way you can memorize. But you have to memorize these eight core missions under the NAPCC. Next, what is important for today's discussion is Saint Kabir. Now, what is important vis-a-vis Saint Kabir is that the year 2018 was the 500th death anniversary of Saint Kabir, as a result of which Kabir and his philosophy is something that becomes very, very important for prelims this year. Now, first and foremost, you should note that he was born in the year 1440 and died in 1518. This being the 500th death anniversary year, this question is something that can be asked directly also. Also, what is important is that he believed in Nirguna Bhakti. Now, this concept is something that is different from Saguna Bhakti. This is something that you should know. This is a conceptual clarity in culture paper. What is important here is that Nirguna Bhakti saints believed in a formless God. They did not believe in worshipping God in the form of an idol. Largely, Sant Kabir and Guru Nanak were the proponents of such kind of bhakti, whereas you should know that the Saguna Bhakti movement considered God as a human form. They believed in Vaishnavism, where, for that matter, Vishnu, Lord Vishnu, was what was considered as an incarnation. So that is what is a different type of bhakti movement, and Nirguna Bhakti is what was professed by Sant Kabir. So this is one question which you can expect. Next, what is important is that he rejected major religious traditions in the world as well as in India. Especially he ridiculed the external worship that was practiced in India. Also, priestly classes and caste system is what Sant Kabir had criticized. So this also can be a question. Next, what is important is that the guru of Sant Kabir was Ramananda. This is one question that can again come. Also, the religious community of Sant Kabir is Kabir Panth, and the followers are known as Kabir Panthi. So that is one thing that is important. Another thing that is important here is that he was the first saint to give universal path to both Hindus as well as Muslims. This can be a question in itself. His ideology, his bhakti movement is not exclusive to Hindus, but rather both to Hindus as well as to the Muslims. Also, he talked about the concept of moksha, which he said was the union of the jivatma with the universal soul, that is the paramatma. His writing, some of his books are what are important. He has written the Bijag, the Kabir Granthavali, the Anurag Sagar, as well as Sakhi Granth are some of the important writings by Sant Kabir. So this is going to be one very, very important topic. Please try and cover it. And wherever you are reading culture also or bhakti movement, focus should be on Sant Kabir. So that's all for our discussion today. I thank you all for watching the video.